technical aspects aside, I have to say I represent 175 million workers around the world. Why are we interested in this? Because when we saw a leaked copy of the draft agreement, it just screamed a net grab. It said someone's trying to control the internet in the interests of two players. Self-interested telcos who want to set pricing policies that would change the way you now use access to Skype or email. And of course, governments, none of whom in the mix of amendments we've seen would be governments you would want to set the rules around control of the internet.
The big issue for me and many others is that attempts to constrain what you can do on the internet lead to potential hazard in the following sense. If you look at the system, it consists of hundreds of thousands of networks that are all operated independently of each other. The decisions that are made by one of those operators are driven by business considerations and other policies. They are absolutely free to decide with whom they interconnect, under what conditions. There is no set of rules and regulations about who you interconnect with and on what terms and conditions. The result has been an incredibly rich and resilient fabric of interconnection of all these various networks.
And I think it raises the question that if the Secretary General doesn't intervene, then how on earth do you have any global oversight on a UN body that simply is racing ahead on its own in relative secrecy?
The attempt to constrain and regulate that on either the bigger international basis would actually do away with flexibility and freedom to build this structure, to build this infrastructure, and to use it. So many of us, including me, are absolutely resistant to attempts to control that.
The massive growth that we have seen that took place in the internet is in many respects because industry, academia, and the community adopted a network protocol that did not come out of the intergovernmental negotiations of the IT process. But some of the member states have been pushing for some significant changes. Some people are arguing, first of all, that it should be shifted from telecommunications, which was basically international telephony, to include all ICT.
I'd urge you to read the draft of the agreement, which I now understand, after a lot of pressure, is public on the internet. I'm not sure that the country's positions are ascribed to each of them, but I can assure you that when we read the initial draft and you looked at the position of certain countries, that it was just an appalling indication of countries who really wanted to silence people they didn't agree with.
And that in the course of that change during the 20 some odd years and 30 years, really, of evolution, the U.S. government has relinquished repeatedly controls or responsibilities or authority over the internet and its operation. This is a very deliberate series of steps taken by the government, recognizing how important it is that this particular infrastructure become part of a global environment.
Where there's been looking for control of how traffic is managed, how traffic is routed, some people looking for control for particularly what they call a security and the implementation of security. And in that security, there are definitions of, for instance, spam. There are definitions of acceptable communications, acceptable data, which start to become interpreted as whose definition of acceptable and whose definition of spam.
You're talking about Saudi Arabia, about Egypt, about Iran, about Russia, about China. Are they seriously governments that are going to be open so that people can both use the internet not just for family communications but for civil society and union networking, activism, support for our members? The answer is no. Already we see battles with censorship in a number of those countries. Already we have battles with corporations who are more interested in profits than in the interests of people and communities. So this must be stopped in this way. No secret negotiations. This is a UN body. And Kumi Naidu, the CEO of Greenpeace, and I wrote to the UN Secretary General just last Thursday saying, stop the net grab. Let's actually have a process where all of the potential impact of any regulation can be assessed from a point of view of business and trade, from a point of view of civil society and political rights and freedoms, and from the point of view of pricing policies that don't make it impossible for the people of the world to communicate with each other. So for me, this is not a process that should happen in secret. It's not a process that the UN should stamp as having legitimacy, where governments will simply negotiate in their own interests at a forum where the public is essentially excluded.